Hey everyone, I thought I'd take a moment to show you guys a few things for exercise 3, which is just really refreshing some of your HTML and CSS experience. So I've got an HTML and CSS file set up already and kind of already pre-coded, and I'll kind of walk you guys through a few things that might help you out. So starting out, I've got three different files that I'm working with. You guys are going to create these from scratch. For the picture, you can really use anything that's school safe. But the actual HTML and CSS file, you're going to start out with your own files that you're going to use creating a text editor. So I've already created these. Some of the things to just remind you guys of. So when you create an HTML file, you have to have your doc type as well as your HTML and head tags. The title tag, which is just the title of your page. And some of the other things for exercise 3 that we're asking you to do, you've got to create a div tag. And we're asking you to use a little bit of CSS. So we've actually given this a class that we're calling main. So when we start to use CSS, we can control the width of it. And then later on down the road, we can do a lot more with it. So, but for this exercise, we're just using it more for the width than padding. We're also going to be able to create headings and paragraphs. So those I've already set up. Just really bare bones, basic HTML at this point that you should remember from your Web Essentials class. But I know some of you guys, it might have been a while since you've taken it, so a little refresher. Most tags in HTML open and close. So basically, I've got the paragraphs opening and closing and the headings. We do ask you to use two different headings just to remind you that you've got a few options. Technically, there's H1 through H6. And then also including an image. So that image we've just kind of put in the same folder. It's just named puppy, and you can see the link is pretty straightforward. It's just puppy.jpg. If you do not remember the coding, I would highly encourage you to break open your books from your previous classes or reference something like W3 Schools for the image code. Alt attribute is just the description, and then we've got a width and height that I know that we've reviewed already this semester. So the width and height is pixel dimensions, and that's something that I looked at in Photoshop, or the Finder sometimes will give you that as well through your operating system. I've also created two links, and this is just two external websites. I've put them in a list more for my organization. That's not necessarily a requirement, but I find it to be a little bit easier for me. The actual links use the A tag, and to link to a file, you basically use the href attribute, which inside of the quotes is where we put the actual link. So you're going to link to a website that you choose, again, something that's school safe, it can really be anything. And those we can test and we can make sure they work later down the road. By default, just HTML is really bland and there's nothing to it. So this is why we're asking you to do this just as a refresher, is to get you back to using tags, basic tags in HTML, but also so that we can get you learning CSS again. So we do want to also learn how to attach our style sheet and use a few styles similar to what our exercise has asked you to do. So we're asking you to change some widths of things, change the font styles, change some colors like your background color and your font colors, and then change some of your link style. So I'll open up brackets again. I'm using brackets, so testing is pretty easy, and it opens up in Chrome. And I go through here and go quickly to my CSS file. And again, I've already typed these out, but just as a refresher for you guys in CSS, we can call any HTML tag. So the first one I've got is body. So to change my background color for my entire page, I use the body tag and then just use the CSS style. Now, if you cannot remember all of these properties and values, which I'll be honest, it's tough to memorize all of them, you can go to resources like W3 Schools and search for whatever your property is or what you're trying to change. And they have a lot of really great resources that give you the code for how you can actually do this. So I would encourage you guys, be resourceful. If you can't remember how, don't expect to memorize it all. So coming back to this CSS file, the next thing I've got in there is my class for my div, which controls my width, which is pixel measurements, and then the padding value is 30, like we've asked you to do. the heading values. We've asked you to come up with two different styles. You can be unique on your own. You don't have to use exactly what I've got here, but I've just changed the font properties. So font family changes my actual font, the font size, and then the color. So you've got some options there. Again, there's a lot of variety you can choose from. Really, the goal is to get you going back into writing properties and values for your CSS rules. And then we've got the paragraph, same thing. We've got to basically style these so that they take over a different style and that you're getting warmed up to learning to use various CSS properties. So these are just a few. You can definitely go further than this if you'd like to, but just a familiarization of remembering how to create the CSS rules. The last one is actually creating the link styles. So we will get into this a lot more depth later down the road, but the A tag is what controls links. So if we use A, it will control the style of all of the link states. And then if we add the hover to it at the end, this basically gives us the ability to control the way the hover state for the link looks. So some of the things to know about that is by default, links are usually like blue and they have an underline. And we can control that so that the underline is gone. So text decoration none turns off that underline. The other thing is we've got font properties, we've got the color. So if we don't want it blue, we can change that. And then we can change it to a bold color. And there's a lot of other properties and values we could use. But this is just a starter, again, getting you guys refreshed to understanding that you have the ability to control these things. Now, the biggest part of this entire exercise is not just creating these two files and getting refreshed with learning the coding, but learning how to connect the two pages together. So if I go back to my file structure, because this is just a really simple exercise, I've just put all the files in the same folder, okay? And we've got to basically link to these files. So I'm going to come back to my HTML file, and I've commented it out in the beginning so that you wouldn't see the styles, but the line of code that we need to be able to link to a style sheet is this line number 6, and it basically links to, right here where it says href, the name of my style sheet. So as long as this name matches the one that is inside of my folders, it should work, okay? Again, we would have to save and then come back and test. So we're going to come right back here and refresh and see if it takes over. And notice how I've got a background color, I've got different colors to my fonts, different font styles. And then I've got some links here that are not that default blue. So you guys can see that we can begin to change the style of our page. The other thing is noticing that we have a width to our website. So if we did not create that div, all of this text will go right up next to the edge. So for the beginning part of the class right now at this point, we're at the point that we need to learn how to create a div and then how to control the width as well as the spacing. So if we had went back and taken out this padding, and I'm just going to comment it out. That space goes away. So that padding actually helps us push things away from other elements, and in this case it's just the browser window. Okay, so we can bring it back and there's our space back. So I'm just learning some of those beginning properties and values. From there, obviously, just if you want to take it a step further and try any other styles, you're welcome to, but at this point just using some basic paragraph heading and other fundamental styles for you guys that are listed in the exercise. So hopefully that helps you guys out. Again, once you're done coding, always test it. Make sure you see it in the browser. Make sure you see the changes that you're wanting to happen. And if you have any troubles, you can reach out to me by email or come ask me in class.